Praise the Lord, everyone. Welcome to God's Hill 7 channel. I'm Sister Barbara, and I have a prophecy I'd like to share with you today. You could join me. I'm going to be in the New King James Version Study Bible. I'm going to be in the book of Exodus, chapter 20, verse 25 and 26. And if you make me an altar of stone, you shall not build it of hewn stone, for if you use your tool on it, you have profaned it, nor shall you go up by steps to my altar, that your nakedness may not be exposed on it. So I looked on the bottom here about the nakedness part, and it says the worship of gods of Canaan involved sexually perverse acts. Nothing obscene or unseemly was permitted in the pure worship of the living God. So I've been praying now for several months to get a breakthrough. And I think I got that breakthrough this morning when I was in my prayer time with the Lord. So this prophecy is titled, the Lord's title, Destruction of Man's Church, His Polluted Church. And here's the prophecy. See the coming destruction of man's church, man's teaching, man's doctrine. Come, my beloved children, gather around, and I will tell you a story. Everything that man has made for himself will be destroyed. Every hewn stone of his temple will be scattered abroad. Every teaching that does not come from me will be silenced. Every doctrine, tradition, and pagan ritual will be removed from my sight. Man's church is not God's church. Man has perverted my word to suit his own agenda. He has twisted my instruction to suit his own fleshly lusts. He has turned away from me and to himself. My church is my bride, refined and purified in the fire. My bride is humble and meek. Look about. Open your eyes and ears to my understanding. Can you see my bride? Look about, for she is among you. Come to me on your knees, you men of this earth. Bow down before your Creator and repent. For the day that burns like an oven is at hand. So, of course, when I got this prophecy message, usually there's words in some of the messages and instruction that I never heard of before. And I did put one up on Facebook this morning. It was the last word I heard during my prayer time, and the word was called unction. And I never heard of that word. I could see the word in my mind, how to spell it. I came down and I looked it up. So that was a word that I didn't know. The other word in this prophecy message that I didn't know, but I wrote it in here, I looked it up later, is hewn. I had no idea what hewn means. I knew how to spell it, H-E-W-N. A hewn stone is a stone made with a tool. Whoa. So apparently the Lord's temple was to be made with uncut stones. I looked that up on something else. Uncut, no hand could touch it or shape it, because the stone temple made by man, and apparently of hewn stone, are profane. They're polluted. Polluted, Numbers 35, chapter 35, 33, 34. You shall not pollute the land in which you live, for blood pollutes the land, and no atonement can be made for the land for the blood that is shed on it. This is interesting. Except by the blood of the one who shed it. So here's another scripture that I got put on. Jeremiah 2:7. And I brought you into a plentiful land to enjoy its fruits and its good things, but when you came in, you defiled my land and made my heritage an abomination. So this is what's coming. Destruction of man's church, his polluted church. So I suggest that you think about yourself and your situation and where you stand with your relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. So I'm calling all sinners again, repent and be baptized in the name of Jesus. You'll receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. You can read about that in Acts 2:38. If you don't personally have a Bible and you have a computer, you could Google the entire Bible on there and you could learn God's living word. You need to do that. And again, I'm proclaiming the acceptable year of the Lord from now until September 23rd, 2015, Yom Kippur, Day of Atonement. And again, this is another painful prophecy. Last week, I put up another one. I think it's called, Shall I Not Punish Them? So we know the Lord's coming back. Interesting here, he's going to destroy man's church, but he says, can you see my bride? I found this so intriguing. My church is my bride, refined and purified in the fire. My bride is humble and meek. Look about, open your eyes and ears to my understanding. Can you see my bride? You should be able to see the bride. You should have discernment. You should know who is the bride. She is among you, says the Lord. So God bless you. Thank you for tuning in to Godseller 7 channel. I have several this morning. Like I said, I got a breakthrough in my prayer time that I've been struggling with for several months. And look out. Here we go.